My dear students, today we are going to learn about the shape functions for a triangular element by using national coordinate system. Actually, last previous classes we discussed the shape functions for a triangular element by using global coordinate system. You know very well about this particular triangular element. That is the first the two units we discussed the line type of element, either one dimensional, 1 degree, or one dimensional, 2 degrees of freedom type of element, etc. But in this unit, we are discussing the two dimensional element. That too, now for easy understanding purpose, we are concentrating on simple triangle element. Okay, in previous classes already, in global coordinate system, we derived the shape functions, but now we will discuss the natural coordinate system, that is the area coordinates. I think you know very well about the different types of coordinate systems, like in global coordinate system, local coordinate system, and natural coordinate system. What is the global coordinate system? Global coordinate system means that is your coordinate axes are away from the element, but in the local coordinate system, your coordinate axis located either any one of the corner of the element. Such type of one we call as a local coordinate system. But if you observe the natural coordinate system, your coordinate axes are located at center of the element. Such type of coordinate system now we call as the natural coordinate system. Now in this topic, we are discussing about the natural coordinate system. With the help of this natural coordinate system, we will derive the shape function for a simple triangle element, that is the simplex element. Now, as per the natural coordinate system, actually, we are defining this particular one in the with respect to the its areas. With respect to its areas, we can write that one as a here. It is the ratio of the perpendicular distance of a point from one side to the altitude of the same side. That one we call as the natural coordinate. That one we call as the natural coordinate. Just observe here, one simple triangle is there. I think you know very well how we have to write the node numbers. Always we have to rotate the node numbers in counterclockwise direction. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it is having a 3 sides, and I taken a one particular point P here, and I represented this particular point P from one of its sides. Suppose if I take this side, its distance is L1, that is the coordinate in natural manner, and if you represent it on 1 3 side, its distance from this particular point is the perpendicular distance is the L2 is there, and if you consider the 1 2 side, its perpendicular distance is the L3. Okay, now as per the natural coordinate system, here it is the ratio of perpendicular distance of a point from one side to the altitude of the same side. That is, suppose if you consider the 2 3 side, the perpendicular distance from any point P to that side, that is here P to this particular 2 3 side distance is a small h1. I consider small h1 to the altitude of the same side, 2 3 side, its altitude is a capital h1. So what is the coordinate L1 in this diagram? L1 is equal to, it is the ratio of small h1 divided by capital h1. Okay, in the same manner, if you want to write and 1 3 side and 1 2 side also, we can represent similarly L2 is equal to small h2 by capital H2, and L3 is equal to small h3 by capital H3. Okay, do you understand my point? Okay, so like that, we can represent the here its coordinates, natural coordinates, with respect to the area coordinates. Why I am calling here area coordinates means The same thing we can represent in the form of areas also. That's why I call these particular coordinates are the area coordinates. Just observe here. Now I will write this A1. That is, if you divide about the center of the element, about the center of the element, entire triangular element, I divide it into the three parts. This is the triangular element A1, and this is the A2, and this is the A3. This is the P point is there. About this particular P point, I divided this particular one into the three number of elements. Okay, so here area, that is the area of the first element A1, and that is the A1 divided by A, A1 divided by A, that is the area A1 divided by A. A, it represents the total area of the triangular element. So here, if you write that particular formula, I think you know very well, the area of the triangle is half into B into H1. That is, H1 is the small, H1, it represents the height of the triangle A1. Okay, in the same manner, area of the total triangular element is half into B into capital H1. That is, here altitude of the entire triangular element is the capital H1 is there. So if you cancel this of B1 and this of B, and remaining thing is the small H1 by capital H1. What is the small H1 by capital H1? This small H1 by capital H1, it represents the natural coordinate of this particular triangular element. Do you understand? So here we derived this particular natural coordinate with respect to the area of the triangular element. That's why we can call this L1, L2, L3 as area coordinates. Actually, its name is natural coordinate, but based on the our observation, we are considering that one is a area coordinate. In the same manner, if you write for the second coordinate and the third coordinate also, A2 by A and A3 by A, I think you know very well, that is a sum A. What is the A? Already I said A. Here A is the total area of the triangular element. What is the total area of the triangular element? Total area of the triangular element is nothing but A. A1 plus A2 plus A3, that is equal to A. So if you write L1 plus L2 plus L3 is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 by A, that is A by A is equal to 1. Why I write this particular term here? Do you understand? I think you know very well about the properties of the shape function. What are the properties of the shape function? Sum of the shape functions is equal to unit value. So if you add all these particular shape functions, L1, L2, L3, that is the its coordinate values. So if you add all this particular one, we got that particular value as the 1. That is here, it satisfies the property of the shape function. So whatever the thing we are deriving, that thing is 100% right. So now here, so okay, it's okay. Now we proved that one as L1 is equal to A1 by A, and L2 is equal to A2 by A, L3 is equal to A3 by A. I know what is the A and what is the A1, what is the A2. Now I think you know the determinant explanation here in the form of the matrices. Area of 2A1 is equal to, I think before class I explained that particular determinant form, 1xxy, that is 1x2y2, 1x3y3. Suppose this determinant, if you expand, that thing is the x2y3 minus x3y2 plus x into y2 minus y3 plus y into x3 minus x2. That is, if you assume x2y3 minus x3y2 is the alpha 1, and y2 minus y3 is the beta 1, and x3 minus x2 is the gamma 1, then we can write that one as the alpha 1 plus beta 1x plus gamma 1 by 2a. That is the shape function N1. Similarly, shape function N2 is equal to L2 is equal to N2. What is the N2? Already we did the same type of thing in previous class. That thing is the N2 is equal to, here in the same form we got
that is alpha 2 plus beta 2 x plus gamma 2 y by 2 a. L3 is equal to N3. What is the N3? N3 is equal to alpha 3 plus beta 3 x plus gamma 3 y. I think you know this particular alpha 2, alpha 3, and beta 2, beta 3, and gamma 2, gamma 3 also. What is that the thing we derived in previous class? That is, suppose if you take this particular alpha 2, I think alpha 2 is the here x1, x3, y1 minus y3, x1. The same manner, beta 2 is equal to here y3 minus y1. Here, gamma 2 is equal to x1 minus x3. Okay, like that we can expand this particular things. Okay, we derived that particular things. That is, we know the basic property. Is it satisfying the basic property? That is why you are expressing the shape functions. The shape functions must satisfy the field variable equation. That's why here our field variable equation also we can write in terms of the shape function pi of x comma y is equal to L1 pi 1 plus L2 pi 2 plus L3 pi 3 L3 pi 3. That is here in the area coordinate system also our shape function here it varies linearly from 0 to 1. But 0 to 1, that is I think while you are discussing the one dimensional line element, I think you have to remember this particular point. Shape function, its value is unit at its own node and 0 at another node. That means here the shape function is varies linearly. In the same manner here also shape function is varies linearly. But this is a plane element, not the line element. How it is varies linearly? From one side to opposite altitude, this one is varies linearly. If you observe here, 2-3 side, shape function, 2-3 side here, this value is the L1 is equal to 0. But while you are moving towards the its altitude, that is the towards the node 1 point, definitely your shape function value becomes the unit value 1. That is, that's why here I drawn this particular shape function lines. Suppose here the shape function value L1 is equal to 0. That is, if you take shape function value either at node 2 or at node 3 or in between at any points, your value becomes 0, L1. L1 value becomes 0. But if you move towards the node 1, here, just after here, just towards node 1, your shape function value is gradually increasing. That is here 0.2 is there, next 0.4, next 0.6, next 0.8. Later, that is whenever you are reaching its altitude. What is the altitude? That is the node 1. Whenever you are reaching node 1, your shape function value is the unit value. That is the L1 is equal to 1 at its own node. At its own node. That's why here it is always satisfying its properties, and not only the particular properties, here we derived that particular shape function as per the natural coordinate system. My dear students, I think you understand this particular point, and next we will go to the another derivation for the two-dimensional element. That is here actually from last to previous classes onwards, we discussed the two-dimensional element. The two-dimensional element is a simplex element. But actually, here different types of two-dimensional elements are there. For easy understanding purpose and theoretical learning easy concept purpose, we chosen the simplex element. But multiplex elements or complex elements are there. We will not concentrate much more on this particular topic, but how to know, we have to learn some of the things on this particular element. That's why now we are going to discuss the next topic, that is the shape functions for a bilinear rectangular element. That is the two-dimensional multiplex element. Two-dimensional multiplex element. Let us observe here, all of you. here I select a one triangular element, I select a one, sorry, I select a one rectangular element, two dimensional rectangular element. Try to observe here, its nodal points are the 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. That is, this is a two dimensional element, that's why I taken this x axis and y axis. That is, in x axis, its length value is the 2p. For my convenience purpose or easy derivation purpose, I taken its dimension as the 2 times of the p. May take even p also, but for my convenience purpose only I taken 2p. In the same manner, another side, that is in y direction, I taken its length of this rectangular element as the 2q. Actually, I selected a small point p on the rectangular element, that is the mn is there. That is the mn is there. Now, and another thing is, what is this pi here? Here, this is the field variable equation. This is the field variable. That is, now we are discussing the scalar. That is not on the vector manner. That is, we are representing in the scalar way. That's why here I take in a one field variable equation. That is, I did not mention its direction. Just I will represent its magnitude only. That is the variation of the temperature and some of the problems we will concentrate it, this type of things. That's why if you observe here, the field variable of this rectangular element, I taken pi in this direction. At each node, respective field variable points are the pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4 are there. Okay, do you understand? Okay, now here this is the field variable. Okay, it's very good. Total how many number of node points are there for this rectangular element? 4 number of nodal points are there. Now, if you want to derive the by using general method, that to global coordinate system, not the natural or local coordinate system, if you want to derive the here shape functions, the first thing, what is our procedure? First of all, we have to write a one simple polynomial equation with the help of polynomial coefficients. How we will write this polynomial equation? We have to select the minimum number of polynomial coefficients. How many number of polynomial coefficients are required here? Do you remember that particular point? Already we discussed it in last topics. That is, here if you observe the this particular element, it consists the 4 number of how many number of nodal points are there? 4 number of nodal points. If 4 number of nodal points are there, definitely we have to select the 4 number of polynomial coefficients, that is a1, a2, a3, a4. That's why while I am writing this particular field variable or polynomial equation, that is here I wrote this one as pi is equal to a1 plus a2m plus a2n plus a4mn. Here why? Because mn. In the earlier cases, while you are writing the these type of equation, simply we taken only one direction. Why? Because that is a one dimensional element, but it is the two dimensional element. That's why while I am writing the polynomial equation, I taken the two variables. The two variables are the m and n. Okay. Now here, that is I think you know. That is a1, a2, a3 are the unknown polynomial coefficients. Now, in this particular case, first of all, we have to find this particular unknown polynomial coefficient. If you find the unknown polynomial coefficient, then here we can easily, with the help of field variable equation, we can easily express the our derivation, that is the shape function. Okay, now let us start our derivation part here. With respect to this particular diagram, just observe this particular diagram here. Based on the diagram, just you see, based on this particular coordinates here, I will write the its coordinate values and field variable value. That is, just observe here, at m is equal to 0 and n is equal to 0, pi is equal to pi 1. That is, here this particular one I take n at m is equal to 0. That is, here mn is there. I am representing this particular value mn. That is, this is the M and this side is the Y direction is the N is there. That's why, suppose this coordinate MN at a point P, M comma N, I say this particular P point as M comma N. If P is equal to, that is M is equal to 0 here. Okay, and N is the in Y direction, N is equal to 0, then Phi is equal to its field variable as a Phi 1. In the same manner, in suppose if I want to indicate the second node point, M is equal to, what is this dimension? 2P, M is equal to 2P and N is equal to in this particular direction, what is the N value? N does not vary. So N is equal to 0 only. M is equal to 2P and N is equal to 0, Phi is equal to Phi 2. And third one is the M is equal to 2P and N is equal to 2Q, Phi is equal to, here this is the node point 3 is there, Phi 3. Here this field variable is the Phi 3. In the same manner, at node point 4, what is the coordinate? Do you understand these coordinate points? Do you, anybody can tell this particular coordinate points? That is, M is equal to, here, about this particular axis, MN axis, about this particular MN axis, that is, here, about this particular axis, what is this particular M value? 0. N is equal to, what is this N value, length value? 2Q. 2Q is there. 2Q. So, M is equal to 0. N is equal to 2Q. Phi is equal to this particular field variable, Phi 4. Just at node point, that field variable is the Phi 4 is there. Okay. Now substitute these particular boundary conditions in the above equation number 1. That is, what is the equation number 1? Just you go upside, upward. What is the equation number 1? We wrote the basic field variable equation with respect to the polynomial coefficients. So, substitute these boundary conditions in that equation. Suppose first boundary condition, if you substitute, Phi 1 is equal to N 1. And here if you substitute the second boundary condition, Phi 2 is equal to A 1 plus 2B A 2. You consider this is the equation number 2 and this one is the equation number 3. And next next we substitute the third boundary condition in the same equation. Phi 3 is equal to, we got this particular relation. A1 plus 2P A2 plus 2Q A3 plus 4PQ. Why? Because here M is equal to 2P, N is equal to 2Q. That's why 4PQ A4. Next fourth boundary condition, this one. Phi 4 also substitute in the same equation. That is the A1 plus 2Q A3. Now if you observe here, that is from the second equation, we know the one of the polynomial coefficient value, one of the polynomial coefficient value A1 is equal to Phi 1. Okay, we found that value as the A1 is equal to Phi 1. Next here, suppose substitute this A1 value in the third equation. If you substitute that A1 value in the third equation, that is A2 is equal to 1 by 2P into Phi 2 minus Phi 1. In the same manner, A1 and A2 values substitute in the fifth equation, or A1 value substitute in the fifth equation. This is the fifth equation. Unfortunately, I did not write here. You must note down that thing. This is the fifth equation. If you substitute in this fifth equation, A1 value, you will get A3. A3 is equal to 1 by 2Q, into Phi 4 minus Phi 1. Then, okay, Phi 4 minus Phi 1. Now, all these values, this value, this is the Phi 4. Okay, this is the Phi 4. Unfortunately, A3. Now, A1, we know the A1, A2, A3. Now we have to find only one more unknown value is the A4. Now substitute all these three values in equation number 4. If you substitute all these values in equation number 4, now here just observe fourth in the fourth equation. Now I substitute a1 value here. Next 1/2b, that is 1/2b, that is a2 value, 1/2b into 5 2 minus 5 1 into 2b plus 1/2q, 5 4 minus 5 1 into 2q plus 4pq into a4. I think here 2p term, here 2p term becomes cancelled. 5 1 plus 5 2 minus 5 1 plus 5 4 minus 5 1 plus a1 4pq is there. Now we have to find a4. a4 is equal to 1/4pq into 5 1 minus 5 2 plus 5 3 plus 5 4. Okay, you observe here. Now actually with the help of boundary condition, after substituting in the field variable equation, we found the unknown polynomial coefficients a1, a2, a3, a4 values. Substitute all that particular four values in basic field variable equation. Once again, if you substitute in the basic field variable equation, here this is the a1 is there, a2 value, substitute a2 value, and then a3 value, okay, and then a4 value. Whenever after substituting all these values in basic equation, and here we have to separate the 5 1, 5 2, 5 3, 5 4. Why? Because 5 1, 5 2, 5 3, we know the scalar quantity magnitude. So that's why we separate that particular thing. Definitely now we will get 1 minus m by 2 p into 1 minus m by 2 q plus here m by 2 p into 1 minus m by 2 q the same manner plus 5 2 into 5 2 here mn by 4 p q into 5 3 plus n by 2 q into 1 minus m by 2 p into 5 4. That is, if you observe this equation, it is in the form of phi is equal to n1 phi 1 plus n2 phi 2 plus n3 phi 3 plus n4 phi 4. Here, what is this form? This is, that is where n1, n2, n3, n4 are the shape functions. Definitely, there is, I think you know the properties of the shape function. Always, you should satisfy the basic properties. That is, what are the basic properties? You know very well. Sum of the shape function values is equal to unit value, and shape functions at its own node is equal to 1, etc. Definitely, these four shape functions must satisfy that particular properties also. Okay, and another thing, here unfortunately I did not express this particular n1, n2, n3, but separately you have to write this particular terms. What are the terms? N1 is equal to 1 minus m by 2p and into 1 minus m by 2q. N2 is equal to m by 2p into 1 minus m by 2q. And here n3 is equal to mn by 4pq. N4 is equal to n by 2q into 1 minus m by 2p. Like that, we will write the shape functions. Okay. Just suppose if you want to cross check that particular shape function, is it satisfy that particular basic properties, just you substitute the basic values in this equation, m and n values, definitely you will get your shape function n1 is equal to 1 and it's at its own node. Suppose here this is our selected rectangular element. Nodal points are 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. N1 is equal to, as per our derivation, N1 is equal to 1 minus m by 2p into 1 minus n by 2q. What is the mn values at node 1? I think you know very well. In the beginning I wrote, what are the mn values at node 1? M and n values are 0 at node 1. If you substitute in this particular case, m and n values are 0. What is the n value, n1 value? N1 is equal to 1. Is it right? That's why shape function at its own node, this value as the unit value. Suppose same n1 I want to cross check at node 2. Node 2, same shape function. Suppose at node 2, what are the coordinates, m and n coordinates? m is equal to 2p, n is equal to 0. This particular term becomes this particular n is equal to 0. N is equal to, if you put 0, this entire term, this term becomes 0. This is the one, is there 1 into entire thing is the this one. 1 minus m by 2p. 1 minus m. M is equal to at node 2. M is equal to what is this one? 2p. 2p term, 2p term becomes cancelled. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Automatically, here n1 is equal to 0. The same manner at node 4. At node 4 also, if you select it, if you consider the coordinate, what are the coordinates? At node 4, m is equal to 0 and n is equal to 2q. Now if you substitute that particular values in this n1 shape functions, definitely n1 is equal to 0. Is it right? That's why your shape function is varies linearly from this 0 to 1, from node 2 to node 1. In the same manner, if you take another side, here also varies linearly. Okay, so like that, your shape function is varies linearly. That is, that value is varies from 0 to 1. That is, at its one node, your shape function value is the unit value. But another node, your shape function value is the 0. So, do you understand? So, it satisfies 100%, it satisfies the basic properties of the shape function. Okay, now, here we will move to the next, it's the continuation. That one is the, suppose field variable pi is expressed in terms of the another set of local coordinates, that is r and s, whose origin is at the center of the element. That is, whose origin is at the center of the element, I am saying. Whenever you are considering at center of the element, what does it mean? It is this natural coordinate system indirectly. Instead of the local coordinate system, I will take the another set of local coordinate, indirectly that coordinates are the natural coordinates. Okay. So, I will take that coordinates axis at the center of the element. You have to remember this particular point. Where we are selecting the axis. Now we are selecting the axis. Try to understand my point. Here, just observe this particular statement. Now, set of local coordinates r and s whose origin is at the center of the element. Okay, do you understand my point? If you take at center of the element, that coordinate system we call as the natural coordinate system. Okay, so now we are deriving that one. No need to derive entire equation. For easy derivation purpose, just I will change the x coordinates. Just you observe the previous diagram, that rectangular element, where m is equal to at center point, I take in the p point, from that particular point onwards, p plus r, n is equal to q plus s. That is, this m is in x direction, n is the y direction. That is, new coordinates I take in, that's why I take in from that particular, that is, now we are selecting not at the selected point is not located at the center of the element. It is somewhat away. Okay, do you understand? That's why I want to replace, instead of m, I will write m is equal to p plus r and n is equal to q plus s. So here, if you substitute that values in our derived local coordinates shape functions, n1 is equal to, we can write that is 1 minus m by 2p into 1 minus m by 2q. That is, here if you express if you expand that particular term, this is the 1 minus m by 2p minus n by 2q plus mn by 4pq. That is, this particular term is the 4pq term I take in LCM. That is, 4pq minus m2q minus n2p plus mn. Okay. Now, here instead of m and n, you substitute the values. That is, m as the p plus r and n as the q plus s. If you substitute those values in this equation, now here we obtain 1 by 4 pq into pq minus ps minus qr plus rs. That is here, if you multiply with the 1 by pq, 1 by 4 into 1 minus s by q minus r by p plus rs by pq. If you take 1 minus r by p term common, we will get 1 minus s by q, that is n1 is equal to 1 by 4 into 1 minus r by p into 1 minus s by q. In the same manner, if we derive the another shape functions n2, n3, n4, those values are n2 is equal to n4 into, sorry, n2 is equal to 1 by 4, 1 plus r by p into 1 minus s by q. In the same manner, n3 is equal to 1 by 4 into 1 plus r by p into 1 plus s by q. N4 is equal to 1 by 4 into 1 minus r by p into 1 plus s by q. Okay. These are the shape functions with respect to the local coordinate systems for a triangular element. Okay. Now we will move to the another topic. For the same rectangular element, if you want to write the shape functions, Lagrangian's interpolation functions for two-dimensional element, Lagrangian's interpolation functions, I think in one-dimensional case also, I explained the same thing. One-dimensional case also, I explained the same thing. Now, with respect to the two-dimension, once again, I want to derive the shape functions with the help of the Lagrangian function. That is here, two-dimensional case, we will indicate the product of the Lagrangian interpolation polynomial in x and y directions can be used to represent the interpolation function of a rectangular element. That is how to consider the product here. That is where, suppose if you write the our field variable equation, phi of is equal to, here phi is equal to simply in simple manner I wrote here n into pi in the form of matrices. That is, n is the n1, n2, n3, n4, pi is the pi1, pi2, pi3, pi4 is there. That is here, if you observe here for the diagram, that is earlier I taken that r and s terms at center of the element, that is the natural coordinates. So with respect to this particular coordinates here, I drawn this diagram, natural coordinate diagram. That is here ni of rs into pi I of rs. Okay. Now here, what is the n? N is the, I think you know this, what is this particular n1, n2, n3, n4? These are all the shape functions. Now this particular shape function, we can write the product of the Lagrangian interpolation function. That is Li of R into Li of S. Not only in one direction, it is a two-dimensional element. That's why we have to consider the product. You have to remember here. Earlier case simply we write Ni is equal to Li of R. But Li of R is equal to earlier case also. If you observe that particular thing, Li of R is equal to in one-dimensional element case, I express that particular term as the, here sigma term is there, sigma term is there, that is R minus Rj divided by Ri minus Rj. Okay. That is, if you want to write L1 of R means R. In which direction R you take? You have to take only that direction R. R you consider in x direction. So now you have to concentrate in x direction coordinates. Whenever you are representing this small r, you have to take in x direction coordinates. No need to consider the y direction coordinates. That is the important thing is there. Okay. Now observe here, Li of R, as per this particular relation, R minus Rj, that is L1. I taken in x direction, That's why r minus in x direction, next node point is the r2 divided by ri. Ri is the 1. R1 minus r2. Similarly, L2. L2 only x direction. R minus r1. J is the first node point. Why I taken, why sir I taken first node point means, just observe this one here, x direction only we have to consider. If I is the first node is there, here we will write L1. If I is equal to 2 means, this is the L2. J is the another one. J, here that is the J, we have to consider the second node, while you are writing the L1 value. And suppose if you want to write L2 value, J you have to take 1. Why? Because why do not you consider 3 and 4 means 3 and 4, if you consider the third node or fourth node, with respect to the L1 and L2, these two node points are in y direction. That's why simply ignore the two node points. You have to consider these two nodes only in x direction. Okay. So that's why here I wrote the term as the r minus r1 divided by r2 minus r1. Next L3 at node 3 here. Okay, L3 of r that is equal to r minus r4, that is the j value is the 4. That is the j value 4. Sir, why 4 units? Only x direction I taken here. Okay, that's why r4, then I is the 3 is there, r3 minus r4. Next, L4 of r, that is the r minus r3 divided by r4 minus r3. Okay, do you understand my point? The same manner, I express the that particular shape functions with respect to the y coordinates, L1 of s, L2 of s, L3 of s, sorry. Unfortunately, I wrote here R, but this is the S term is there. Please take correction. Next, L4 of S. Okay. Now, here, now, this, in this particular way, we can simple manner, we can express our shape functions. Okay. Now, but the nodal interpolation function, this is the important thing. How to remember? The nodal interpolation functions Ni is a bilinear since they are defined as the product of two linear functions. It is not a single linear function. It is a product of two linear functions. That's why in the beginning also, I wrote a one small equation. Remember, where Ni of Rs is equal to Li into R, Li of R plus Li of S, product of the two functions, shape functions. Okay, so like that, like that, you can express the shape functions for which element? Bilinear or rectangular element in simple manner. In which method we wrote these equations? Lagrangian method. This is the one of the easiest method. If you understand this particular concept, no need to by heart all these particular things. You can easily write the equation also, very easiest one, this particular one. That's why some of the textbooks, actually some standard textbooks, they are solving with respect to the natural coordinate system, most of the problems. Okay, now we have plenty of time. I will continue my class. That is a part of the triangle. Earlier also, we wrote the particular Pascal's triangle. I think we will write in this particular manner, 1xy, x square, that is, this one is the, in this particular manner, its degree value is gradually increases. Next, its product. This particular one is the, this direction, y degree value is gradually increases. Here, in between, we will get the product. Suppose, observe here, xy. The product we will get. Next here, we observe the same. These two, this is x square and this particular first product. Next, this one is the y square. and this particular first product. So like that we will express. This is the cubic. This is the this one is the constant one. Next one is the here linear one is there, quadratic, cubic. Okay, so like that we can express. I think what is the advantage of this particular Pascal triangle? That is, whatever the displacement shapes should not change with the change of local coordinate system. That particular thing we generally we call as the geometry of isotropy or geometric invariance. We call that one as the geometric invariance. In our problems, we have to achieve the geometric invariance. That means we have to balance. That is, whatever the equation we are selecting or whatever the field variable expression you are writing, that equation balancingly satisfy the your field variable. That is, how many number of polynomial coefficients you are considering, in which direction you are considering, and another thing is what is the degree of your equation. All these things are influencing your field variable equation. So now suppose if you observe this particular thing here, suppose if you want to write a one polynomial equation with the help of four terms only, which terms you will consider? First is the one constant term, next this one, next this one. Why? Because only one degree. Next, how many terms are completed? 1, 2, 3. One more term you require. Don't put this x square or this y square. You have to take xy. How to take xy? That's why earlier for rectangular element also we express the with a four term polynomial equation in this particular manner. Pi is equal to a1 plus a2m plus a3n plus a4mn. Do you remember? Okay. But I did not write a4 x m square or a4 y square. Why? Because after writing these two, I have to give the priority to this one. But if I want to express in six terms polynomial equation, at that time this four is there, another one fifth one, and next one is the sixth one. Like that. here we have to express our polynomial equation. So for obtaining of geometric invariance, that is balancing of our polynomial equation with the help of this particular Pascal's triangle, we can easily express the polynomial equations. So so we can easily write the polynomial equations. That's why we will use this particular Pascal triangle. Okay. Next one is the next. Here, I think, what are the applications? What are the applications? Generally, we will use this particular two-dimensional element problems. In the beginning class also, I explained this particular thing. Same thing. Some small points I wrote here. That is, the concept of vector variable problems is applied to find the resultant displacement stresses in case of the plates under biaxial loading and the bending of the plates. There is a plane stress condition and plane strain condition, and these type of conditions are biaxial loading conditions, a bending of the plate conditions. We will apply this particular one and we can calculate or we will find the displacement values and respective stress values, strain values, etc. So these type of things are there. Now here almost all time is completed. The remaining part I will continue in the next class. I'm very thankful to you. If you have any doubts, next class all of you come with the proper doubts. Okay, and go through this particular material. If you have any doubts without any hesitation, please ask me. Okay, thank you.